Today I'm going to show you how to install the M5stack. So we use a USB-C cable, and then we connect to the USB-C here. So the file that we use, in here we have two file that you can download from M5stack.com. First, it's a CP, it's a driver file, and then you install CP, for mine is a 64 bit, so I install. And then click yes. And then this silicon lab driver. So how you know that your device is working? So you go to device manager. Then click on port. Makes you port here. Port here. If it's connected, they have the silicon lab here. So you all done for the driver. The second one, we go to the burner, M5 burner. Then you click on M5 burner to install. If you highlight, they have many type of firmware. This is a USB 4 for the stick. And they have the download here. And you click the download, but this one we install US for 1.2.3. Then you click erase. So it start to erase to finish. Then burn. This one doesn't work, so click burn again. Normally the burning will have lighting for 100% for 2 times. So this will install the firmware. And you can see that the M5stack now is dark because it's installed a new firmware. So you wait for the second round of 100%. After you finish this, we're going to the GUI. So this all done. Click done. Then go to the last one. M5stack. Go to UIFlow-IDE. Turn on to open. So they say doesn't detect the driver. I'm not sure why they default that, so but it skip it. But it detect content, and then click OK. This one, connecting to the content, and we pay. So they say that no remote data. The reason is that we need to go to the M5stack here. When you take it off, then turn it on. Turn on the M5stack. Okay, and then you click this button at the beginning. You need to do really fast, and then you're going to select and save it to USB mode. There are many things here, like go to Wi-Fi connection and the link to the server, but we select the second one because we connect the cable, USB-C cable, then you select. Now they show your API key. This one for the web browser, UIFlow for web browser, you can use for the IoT. But in this one, we are going to show you how to use the cable instead. So you go to example. Then you select some of the example that and then loading. So the example of battery, then click pay. So they say execute completely, and you can see it's result. Okay, thank you for watching.